ChatGPT just announced their GPT marketplace is open for all users, all the free users. And in today's video, we're going to talk about why that's important for you, how you can make money. And quite frankly, if you're into that, now's the time to hit subscribe. All right, so let's read this article here. Using GPTs on our free tier, a frequently asked question guide. So ChatGPT is now free to use. And free tier users have limited access to GPTs in our GPT store as capacity permits. In my experience, up till now, it's been solid. You can find a lot of custom GPTs. GPTs are custom versions of ChatGPT that users can tailor for specific tasks or topics by combining instructions, knowledge, and capabilities. They can be as simple or as complex as needed, addressing anything from language learning to technical support. And I'll put a link right up here to a video that I recorded on how you can actually create your GPTs quickly and how you can monetize them, how you can generate income if you're a consultant, coach, if you want to drive traffic to a blog or to a book or to a paid service. GPTs are a great way to leverage that underpriced attention. The big knock, the big problem was you could only market your services to premium users, people paying $20 a month, which quite frankly, if you want to use the most powerful tool in the history of the world, $20 a month is probably not too bad. It's probably worth it. Regardless, now everyone can use it. It's completely free and it's super cool. So again, check out that link and learn how to make money, how to program your GPT. It's all right there. Let's keep reading here. Are there rate limits associated with GPTs? GPT-4 Omni rate limits are shared between GPTs and ChatGPT. When you hit your text rate limit for GPT-4o, you won't be able to use your GPTs until your rate limit resets. If you reach a rate limit for any of the following tools, you will need to wait for a later time to use any of these tools with a GPT. Data analysis with ChatGPT, file uploads, and browsing with ChatGPT. And basically what this is saying is that these models work off of tokens. And once your tokens are used up, once you've used the program enough or a certain amount, they're going to make you wait before you use it again. And this was a problem that I was running into on the free tier. So I said, listen, I'm using ChatGPT a lot. I'm creating all these automations. It's probably worth just paying for the premium. Then I get essentially what equates to tons and tons of use. So again, that is the limit. If you're using ChatGPT a lot, eventually you're going to need to pay the $20 a month to have a seamless usage experience. Is performance for GPTs different for users on the free tier? GPT usage on the free tier is subject to the same limitations as ChatGPT, GPT Advanced functionality, including data analysis, file uploads, web browsing, and DALL-E are all subject to stricter rate limits. They're going to require more processing power. As a free user, you won't be able to use DALL-E and also may hit tighter limits for advanced capabilities. When you hit these limits, you'll see the following message. You've reached your limit for using GPTs, upgrade to ChatGPT Plus, or try again later. So again, if you're trying to generate images and stuff like that, you're gonna have a hard time. That requires more data usage. And at a certain point, if you're getting that message enough, congratulations. Congratulations, you are now using the most powerful tool in the history of the world. It's probably worth paying $20 a month to get a better experience. Additionally, there may be some differences in how GPTs behave using different models, making the experience for GPTs for free users less performant than our paid tiers. Again, I play with it a little bit and it seems solid to me. I haven't noticed much of a difference. Can I use GPT to generate images? GPTs that generate images use DALL-E, and we currently do not support the ability to generate images with DALL-E in our free tier. DALL-E capabilities are available to all users on Plus, Team, and Enterprise plans. And by the way, I found that the ChatGPT AI generation with DALL-E is really, really good. Not up to the level of Midjourney. Midjourney is still going to be number one for image generation, but the images that you can generate with ChatGPT are super slick, super slick. Can I rate a GPT as a free tier user? Currently, users on the free tier cannot leave a rating for a GPT. And then lastly here, it says, can I create a GPT on a free tier user? Currently, only Plus, Team, and Enterprise plans can have access to our GPT builder. Now, again, I would encourage you to check out that video because I show you exactly how you can create a GPT that drives additional streams of revenue. It can stream traffic to your website, traffic to any paid programs that you offer. You can share affiliate links and stuff like that. And why that's valuable, more valuable now than it was in the past, is you can create these GPTs. You can program them very quickly in like less than 10 minutes. You could program a bunch, put them on the GPT store, drive traffic, and now the whole world has access. People that, it's not just the paid community that has access to the GP store, it's everybody. And here I am on one of my free accounts here, and you can see on the GPT store, there's all kinds of featured GPTs here. I mean, there's a ton. So this is interesting, image generator. And you know, we just read that you can't actually generate images, but I'm going to try this here. Let's start a chat here. Because if it says that we can't do it, I want to test it to make sure it's correct. Generate an image of Mark Savant using ChatGPT to make money. And let's see what happens here. I'm going to fast forward. Okay, and it says, I cannot create images right now. So just like our guide told us, you want to generate images, you need to be on the paid plan. Let's look at some more of these GPTs here. Write for me, write tailored, engaging content, scholarship GPT. And, you know, so by the way, when it comes to not being able to generate images, if you're developing a GPT, a custom GPT for the masses, and you want free users to be able to use it and have a good experience and drive traffic, it should not have any image generation attached to it. So this is kind of funny that the top trending GPT is an image generator, which cannot be used by people on the free tier. So again, if you want to reach everyone, definitely don't be using stuff that's doing data analysis, right? It's you're not doing data analysis. You're not supporting file uploads, web browsing, DALL-E. If you want to create GPTs that are going to drive traffic to what you do, you don't want any of this stuff. Just, I would say something like, for example, I have a podcast consultant GPT. It doesn't do any of that stuff. It's just saying, ask questions, get answers. And I think that's more so where you're going to want to be on the free GPT tier. So anyway, super interesting. Wanted to pop on here and explain this. I think it's very valuable to anyone who's trying to think differently and find new ways to support communities, generate more income. This is the place to be. And by the way, if you are really wanting to keep up with this stuff, you have to subscribe to my newsletter. Bro, I'm giving it all away for free on the newsletter at AIUpdate.ai. That's AIUpdate.ai. When you sign up, I'm even going to give you a free gift, completely free gift for you. Go to AIUpdate.ai to get that. It's free. What are you waiting for? Go hook it up. All right, I'll see you in the next video. Peace.